Hey guys, Drifter here, welcome to Modern Warfare in Depth. In today's episode, I wanted to let you know that the Merc Foregrip is kind of amazing. We've got some base multiplayer here in the new map Hard Hat. I haven't had a whole lot of base MP going on for this series in a while, so I do hope that you enjoy it, and we'll have Warzone later. Now, when I initially measured the Merc Foregrip many months ago when the game came out and I tested all of the various recoil attachments and got together with Ace and we tried to figure all these things out, the results I got was that the Merc Foregrip was nearly useless. It was one of the worst attachments in the game, and I wouldn't really recommend it for hardly anything. But a lot of you recommended that I test it, and the pros use it, and this and that, and my, you know, both of my best classes, you told me to use Merc instead of Commando, so I decided to listen to the audience, sit down, and give it a test, and lo and behold, it appears to have been buffed, and is now by far the best grip to put on most weapons, and this buff is not insignificant. Apparently I'm a caveman for not knowing this. Clayster was sent to see on Twitter the other night saying that it's been really good the whole time. I actually reached out to Exclusive Ace about it, and he said that he tested it 4 or 5 days ago and it was better, but he's not exactly sure when it was buffed because previously he agreed it was kind of useless. So what we're going to do today is break down this attachment. I'm going to tell you why it's so good and why you should be putting it on more weapons. And if you just look at the description of it, it'll tell you that it reduces your hipfire spread and reduces your vertical recoil. So you have better hipfire and less kick on your guns. And the first thing we want to take a look at is that hipfire claim. The best way to show this off is actually in my editing program, which is Adobe Premiere. And what you're looking at right now is the base MP5 zoomed in 3 times so we can see triple big hipfire box. And when I turn on the one that has the Merc Foregrip, you can see it actually gets a little bit tighter. It's not perfectly aligned, aiming in exactly the same spot, but it's close. And as I can swap back and forth, you do see that the Merc Foregrip does have slightly tighter hipfire. I would call that maybe 5 or 10%. It's honestly kind of hard to measure. And a similar story is being told with the MP7. When I go to the base MP7, you can see that it's fairly wide. When I turn on the Merc Foregrip, it tightens up about 5 or 10%. But that's not really the interesting part. The interesting part is how it affects your hipfire recoil. The next thing I want to show you is the rate of hipfire spread, or how quickly your box hits its maximum size. I tried to sync these files up so that each one is shooting their first bullet on the first frame here. This is, if I'm not mistaken, the Merc Foregrip, and I'm going to turn on the base MP5, which you can see is a little bit heavier. And I've kind of got this opacity thing going on so that it's we can just make it a little bit more transparent and easy to see. But as I continue and the guns fire, you will see that one is consistently a little bit smaller than the other all the way through, and this does account for the slight offset in firing too. And as we continue, that offset becomes less significant, and it pretty much just comes down to how quickly your gun is firing or how synced that is. But for the first, I think I counted 7 shots here, one of these hipfire boxes is just always tighter than the other, and therefore more accurate, and that's going to be the one with the Merc Foregrip. So basically it does slow down the rate at which your hipfire spreads and gets you a first couple of shots of hipfire tighter. But after, at least on the case of the MP7, 7 shots, and most of the gun are somewhere between 5 to maybe 9 total shots on the Uzi, then there's pretty much no difference as we move further into the clip. As you can see, they have essentially the same magnitude and maybe like a frame or two offset from when each bullet is firing. The next thing I wanted to show you is with the MP7 here. I'm going to go ahead and layer on the base MP7 on top of the Merc Foregrip MP7 so we have our little ghosting image. And as we move through this clip, it tells a pretty similar story as the regular MP5. You know, you can see that, yeah, the Merc Foregrip's a little tighter, but it's not crazy. But as we push through, I want you to pay attention to the height of the target, the height of the wall, and the height of the map obstructions. Because the further we move, the more you'll notice that offset is there. So I'll do this muting on and off. I'll actually turn the opacity up here, and you can see that the Merc Foregrip is actually maintaining a lower and more stable presence on the target than the base MP7, which means the Merc Foregrip affects your hipfire box recoil itself. I'm going to go ahead and turn the opacity back on, and we'll see how extreme this can get. And let's go down near to the end of the clip. That's probably about our max magnitude right there. This is the difference, and that's not necessarily tightening your hipfire box, but it will make it more easy to control, which is a nice benefit if you plan to be hipfiring a lot. After all of that, the results indicate that the Merc Foregrip will minorly reduce hipfire spread by about 5 to 10%. This is going to be the overall weakest hipfire altering attachment, and that's not a massive gain on the box size itself. However, it does also slow down the growth and spread rate of the hipfire box for the first some number of shots, and this number of shots will vary by weapon. In my experience, it's somewhere between 5 and 7 shots will have less hipfire box spread than a weapon that doesn't have the Merc Foregrip. And finally, the Merc Foregrip does seem to help lower the vertical kick of your hipfire box itself, because even when you're hipfiring the box, your gun will move up and your screen will drag up because your camera point of view rotates. That's just kind of how they coded it. So neither one of these individually is that amazing. I wouldn't say that it's worth it, but the fact that you have a little bit tighter spread, a little bit slower spread, and then a little bit less vertical kick means that your hip fire will get improved by a little bit. I don't think it's quite as good as the 5 milliwatt laser, but it's probably just as good, if not better, than the 1 milliwatt laser. In most cases, there's a lot of weird attachments you can put on guns and oddballs and outliers and whatever. These are minor buffs, and I think that they are going to be hard to notice for most players. If you're a really good, really competitive, sweaty player, you'll probably be able to notice these, but these are going to be right on that sort of borderline where casual players won't be able to tell it's much better. The next claim is that the foregrip will help with vertical recoil, which, as we know in Call of Duty, what the description says and what the attachments do are not always the same thing. So I ran through 4 weapons that I use pretty frequently to test out the recoil, and these are the results. This is my testing with the MP5, the base MP5 on the left, the Merc is the second one, the Ranger is the third one, and the Commando Grip is the fourth one. I'm going to repeat this pattern all the way through the testing, and as you can see, the Merc Foregrip has the least amount of vertical kick. And most importantly, when you look at it, it has a very tight cluster of the first, honestly, almost 3, 4, 5 shots on this weapon. Whereas for the base, the Ranger, and the Commando Foregrip, your initial shots are much more spread out. They are not nearly as on top of each other as the Merc Foregrip, and that is a massive advantage. Taking a look at the Ram 7, which we'll have gameplay of as well, you'll see that the Merc Foregrip has a significant vertical recoil reduction. It also seems to help a little bit with the horizontal. The Ranger Foregrip, which is supposed to be all about vertical recoil, is just not as useful, and the Commando makes it predictable, at least, but still quite a lot of kick. And again, if you take a look at this, you'll notice that the first shots are a little bit closer on the Merc Foregrip than any of the others, except maybe the Commando, but it seems to be tightening up your initial spread as well, which is very important. This was on the Striker 45. I had to crop it kind of funny. It's like barely in there. Same pattern, base, Merc, Ranger, and Commando. And you'll see the same pattern again. The Merc clearly kicks the least, and the initial shots are tighter than any other. I will say the Commando adds a lot of consistency to your recoil. So the Commando Grip really is about helping your precision, whereas the Merc Foregrip is about helping your overall accuracy. And decided to put this bad girl on the AK-47, since that gun has a lot of recoil. And again, a pretty similar pattern emerges, that the Merc Foregrip has the least vertical recoil, and the first shots tend to be clustered a little bit closer than most. Interestingly, on this one, the base AK-47 had 2 shots on top of each other, and the Merc Foregrip did as well, whereas the Ranger and Commando Foregrips did not. The first shot jumped quite a bit. That could be due to randomness, but it's pretty similar to the patterns we've seen before, so I would say it's probably the effect of the grip. What this means is, at the end of the day, the Merc Foregrip reduces vertical recoil more than any other grip, at least any other grip that I've seen. There might be some outlier weapons or weird combinations or something, but everything seems to indicate that it has a significant impact on your vertical recoil. I would personally estimate about a 5 to 10% recoil reduction, which is quite good for a game like this. It helps your consistency, and you're supposed to be stacking attachments for various things that will get that a little bit higher over time. Interestingly, it also seems to tighten up the spread on your first 2 to 3 shots quite a lot, which is not something that's advertised in the description, and it's not something that the other foregrips do. And to be honest, this is probably more valuable than the overall vertical recoil being lowered. Having your first 2 to 3 shots be tighter and on target killing people is better for base multiplayer and for Warzone. So at the end of the day, the Merc Foregrip seems to have better overall recoil reduction than any other grip, and it helps your hipfire, and it helps almost everything. In many ways, it statistically dominates anything other than the commando grip on some special weapons. There are some weapons, kind of like, say, the Growl, where you want a very consistent recoil pattern, where the commando grip might be a little bit better over time than the Merc Foregrip, but it's honestly a pretty close race right there. There is a single downside to the Merc Foregrip. I wrote downsides because I was trying to find more. But if you run this, you're going to get about 1 to 2 frames slower aim down sights time depending on your weapon. In most cases, it was 1, in a few cases, 2. I guess if I tried this on LMGs, I might be able to get 3 frames slower. It seems to kind of scale per weapon class. But 1 to 2 frames slower ADS seems to be the only penalty that I can see with the Merc Foregrip. And I think that the benefit to penalty ratio is extremely good on this, almost pure bonus. And I will gladly take that 1 to 2 frames of slower aim down sights time to make not only a significant improvement to my first shot's accuracy, but also a noticeable improvement to my vertical recoil and a nice little bonus for my hipfire as well. So I get a lot of like bonuses spread around with the Merc Foregrip. Because of this, a lot more of my weapons in Warzone and in base multiplayer now have the Merc Foregrip attached. Not all of them, but I've replaced it with quite a few weapons. Most notably, I think the Merc Foregrip really helps out some of the very high recoil weapons like the Ram 7. I played a lot tonight in Warzone with the Ram 7 running the Merc Foregrip on it instead of some of the attachments I had been running, and I will say that it subjectively feels really good on this weapon and makes it much, much better and helps it be more competitive at longer ranges because your recoil is just going to be tighter and your first shots don't bounce as much. So I've been doing a lot of Ram 7 work with it. I'm going to keep testing it out. Also hipfire with the Ram 7 when you like push people in close quarters and all. So I think it's a strong attachment. I think a lot of you should be using it. If you play multiplayer, great. If you play Warzone, great. It's great for both. I hope that you enjoyed this episode of In Depth. I hope that you learned something useful. If you did, don't forget to like, favorite, and subscribe. Drifter out.